Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the entire editorial page of the Hindu dated 27th of May. Now first of all we need to know about what different type of editorials we have for the day. First of all, we have a very important editorial that you can use for General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Now this is the lead and the sub-lead editorial. Now the lead editorial, primarily it deals with the new kind of India that is emerging. That what India is witnessing is a kind of new type of nationalism. And in the sub-lead editorial, we have an important editorial related to the death anniversary of Jawaharlal Nehru. Now in this sub-lead, we'll be discussing about what Jawaharlal Nehru stood for, Jawaharlal Nehru ki kya ideology thi, aur us ideology ko kis tarah hum undo kar rahe hain, kis tarah hum Jawaharlal Nehru ki jo legacy hai usko khatam kar rahe hain. So this is the main theme about this editorial, the sub-lead editorial. Now then you have us. Third is top corner editorial. This relates to the cabinet decision to do away with the Foreign Investment Promotion Board and how the revoking of Foreign Investment Promotion Board will lead or will promote the ease in attracting the foreign investment in India. तो इसके क्या क्या repercussions होंगे, इसका critical analysis है. अगर इस editorial का nature देखें तो ये critical analysis है, और अगर इस editorial का nature भी देखें, this editorial is more about the critical about the Narendra Modi government's policies, approach and ideology. And then you have is the bottom corner editorial. Now this bottom corner editorial, it relates to United States of America's relationship with the NATO forces and how this relationship is getting deteriorated with it day by day. Now we will start with the bottom corner editorial, that is USA and NATO's relationship. Now NATO came into being after Second World War. NATO has resulted in creating a world order, that is the liberal world order. NATO's main intention and main purpose was to put forward the interest of United States of America and that of European countries economically, politically and socially. So the type of milli, type of economic milli and social and political milli that we have presently, it is all guarded, or it was till now guarded by the NATO forces. So the type of globalization system that we have now, if from economic perspective, and the type of the ideological system that we have at the world over, that is the liberal system. Liberal system ka kya matlab hai? Ki human rights ki value karni hai, ek aadmi ki value karni hai, ek aadmi ko independence dena hai, taaki wo strive karke achhe results yield kar sake. So this type of ideological setup, this type of economic system based on capitalism and the social system, social culture, social globalization that promotes the Western and the modern ideas. So important word here is modern ideas. You have the classical age, you have the modern age, and then you have the postmodern age. So the Western world ne sab kuch promote kiya hai, European countries ne milke United States of America ke saath, ye tino cheezon ko jo promote kiya Second World War mein, now all this was guarded by the NATO forces. क्योंकि अगर आपको कोई भी आइडियोलॉजी को प्रमोट करना है, आपको मिलिटरली अपने आप को स्ट्रेंथन करना पड़ता है, और यूएसए और नाटो फोर्सेस ने ये बहुत अच्छे से अब तक किया था, अपने आप को गार्ड. बट ऑफ लेट यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका अंडर द न्यू डिस्पेंसेशन हैज बीन क्रिटिसाइजिंग दिस एस्पेक्ट ऑफ नाटो, दैट नाटो इज बीइंग बजटेड मोर बाय यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एंड लेस बजटेड by the European countries. कि European countries को भी बहुत ज़्यादा फायदा हो रहा है NATO forces का, उनके borders बहुत अच्छे से secured हैं, और ये policy, social policies जो world over है, economic policy है, political policies है, बहुत अच्छे से entrench कर रही हैं, but they are not paying the share of the amount that they should be paying. अगर नाटो का एक्ट पढ़ते हैं, नाटो की जो ट्रीटी है जिसके अंडर नाटो बना था, द मेन थिंग अबाउट द फाइनेंस इज दैट एवरी कंट्री हु विल बी पार्टिसिपेंट ऑफ द नाटो विल बी पेइंग 2% ऑफ देयर जीडीपी एंड रेस्ट ऑफ दैट विल बी पेड बाय यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. बट नाउ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका बिकॉज ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक डाउन टर्न सिंस 2008 से आर्थिक स्थिति काफी खराब हो गई है ग्लोबल. नाउ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका इज फीलिंग द पिंच ऑफ दिस. And now it's now it wants that it should not only be giving or financing this entire NATO forces, rather the financing of the NATO forces should also be done by the other European countries. Now the third editorial that you have, it is important from GS mains examination paper 3. It is about Foreign Investment Promotion Board. Now cabinet has taken a decision to do away with Foreign Investment Promotion Board. Now they have revoked this Foreign Investment Promotion FIPB just in order to give a push to the investment, the foreign investment in India. But this decision is not very substantive. The reason for that are, first of all, through this FIPB route only 10% of the foreign investment is done. Rest of the investment is done through 90% of the investment is done through automatic route. So 90% jo investment hai automatic route se aati hai, 10% hi sirf investment hai jo foreign investment promotion board se aati hai. And isko dur karne ka koi fayda nahi hai, because even if you're increasing the limit of the investment that the foreign players can do in a particular sector, if you're raising the caps, so the important word is raising the caps here. अगर आप कैप्स भी रेज कर रहे हो उसका भी बहुत ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं है. द रीज़न फॉर दैट इज बिकॉज डिस्पाइट रेजिंग द कैप्स इन द न्यूमरस सेक्टर्स, देर आर सर्टन इकोनॉमिक राइडर्स अटैच्ड विद ऑल दीज सेक्टर्स. नाउ इन दिस एडिटोरियल द ऑथर हैज डिस्कस्ड अबाउट, द एडिटोरियल टीम ऑफ द हिंदू हैज डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर. अभी इंश्योरेंस में इन्वेस्टमेंट 49% अलाउड है, बट मैनेजमेंट इंडियन प्लेयर करेगा. So this is something that is prohibiting जो बाहर वाले लोग हैं जो इन्वेस्टमेंट करना चाहते हैं हिंदुस्तान में, वो नहीं हो पा रही है. एंड देन यू हैव इम्पॉर्टेंट इशू विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द फूड प्रोसेसिंग. अगर फूड प्रोसेसिंग में नॉन फूड आइटम्स नहीं आप रख सकते अगर आप इनकी सेल करते हो, अगर आप फूड प्रोसेसिंग में इंडल्ज होते हो. सो सच काइंड ऑफ राइडर्स, सच काइंड ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेटिक लॉज एंड रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस आर नॉट अलाइंग the complete reaping of this sector of foreign investment in the various economic sectors. So it is important that you should not only be doing with this FIPB, but you should also remove these riders from the various sectors. Now then we have the second important sub-lead editorial about Hindu, about Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru. Now when it comes to Jawaharlal Nehru, he had always wanted to establish a left-oriented India. A left-oriented India which should be secular in nature. He was always against establishing a type of India which has the rightist tinge. The right tinge means he was against RSS. He was against any Hindu fundamentalist organization when he was the Prime Minister, because he believed that such kind of organizations, they are not in favor of nationalism. They are actually promoting the idea of anti-nationalism. He wanted a secular India where minorities feel safe, where minorities have an important space and place for them. Har ek kisi domain mein, chahe wo economic domain hai, chahe wo social domain hai, chahe wo political domain hai. हर एक डोमेन में माइनॉरिटी को एक रिस्पेक्टेबल प्लेस मिलना बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है एज पर जवाहरलाल नेहरू. बट दिस इज समथिंग दैट हैज़ बीन अनडन बाय द रीसेंट डिस्पेंसेशन. नाउ द रीसेंट डिस्पेंसेशन इज मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द राइटिस्ट अप्रोच, टूवर्ड्स द फंडामेंटलिस्ट अप्रोच, वेयर बाय इट इज़ नॉट अलाइंग द लिबरल फोर्सेज टू रिमेन इंटैक्ट. लिबरल फोर्सेज को अलाउ नहीं कर रहे हैं, सेकुलरिज्म को अलाउ नहीं कर रहे हैं. अभी अलाउ किसको किया जा रहा है? हिंदी, हिंदू एंड हिंदुस्तान. दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ आइडियोलॉजी दैट इज बीइंग प्रोपगेटेड बाय द करंट डिस्पेंसेशन. Now, when it comes to the first editorial, it is about the new type of the nationalism that is being promoted in India. Nationalism in which you are not allowed to speak. Nationalism in which you are not allowed to indulge in debate and discussion. Nationalism in which you speak, it will be characterized as if you are indulging in sedition. So dissent is not allowed, no longer allowed, because this is the new type of dispensation, new type of nationalism that is being promoted. Now the most important thing, because of the shield of nationalism, whatever illegal is being done in India is again being protected. Illegal action that was recently taken by an army officer in Jammu and Kashmir, where he had tied up one person in front of the jeep in order to protect the army men from the stone pelting. So he was actually indulging in an illegal act to stop the people from pelting the stones. So such kind of actions are being shielded by the shield of nationalism. आप राष्ट्रवाद का नारा देके इन सब गलतियों को, जो भी कोई कर रहा है उनको प्रोटेक्ट किया जा रहा है. अगर इन द नेम ऑफ गौ रक्षक्स क्या कर रहे हैं, कुछ लोगों को मार रहे हैं, लिंचिंग इंसिडेंट्स बहुत सामने आ रहे हैं, तो ये एक नए तरह का नेशनलिज्म है जो प्रमोट किया जा रहा है. ये नए तरह का नेशनलिज्म है राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन के बिल्कुल अगेंस्ट है. So this was all for the editorial class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.